Hi everyone, welcome to Crypto Market, the educational channel about cryptocurrencies. Today, I want to show you the new Trezor Safe 3 cryptocurrency hardware wallet. In this video, I am going to show you step by step how you should configure this wallet, and I'm also going to show you how to receive and send the famous Solana cryptocurrency. In future videos, I will show you examples with other cryptocurrencies. So, please stay until the end of this video, because it is full of very interesting information. I'm going to start by showing the packaging. This is how your wallet arrives. Look, it is completely sealed. Inside the box you will find the device, which is also sealed, to ensure that no one has tampered with it. The user's manual. Some stickers. Two cards to write the seed words, and a USB Type-C cable. See how the device comes completely wrapped by a security sticker. And here, in the area where it connects, it has an additional security seal. If you still don't have this hardware wallet, in the video description, you will find the link so you can go directly to the official site and can order in complete safety. Remember that by purchasing from the official site, you have the guarantee that the device has not been tampered with by anyone. To begin the configuration, you are going to enter trezor.io/start. Select the app option. Here you can choose two options. You can download the Trezor suite to your computer, or you can use the Trezor suite for web. You choose the one you like the most. For this video, I am going to download the application to my laptop. Once the suite is installed, you open it and connect the device to continue. Here you select Set up my Trezor. The first step is to install the firmware. This is very important. If you want to use this Trezor wallet only to store Bitcoin and don't want to store any other cryptocurrency, I recommend you to install this firmware. But if you want to use the wallet to store Bitcoin and additionally all the cryptocurrencies available in the wallet, you must install this universal firmware. I am going to store Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies, so I am going to choose the universal firmware. For me, this is excellent. Once the installation is complete, the next step is to check the device, that the chip is genuine and everything is fine so that you can use it safely. Select Start, and now you confirm on the device. And that's it. Here the notification appears that the Trezor wallet is perfect for storing your cryptocurrencies. The next step is to know the device. This device is actually very easy to use. Anyway, let's take a quick look at it. Here on the screen, you will see instructions to understand how to use it. Here it appears. Hello, welcome to Trezor, press right to continue. Use Trezor by clicking the left and right buttons. Continue right. So I'm going to press the right button. Press and hold the right button to approve important operations. So I hold it down for a few seconds and confirm. Press right to scroll down to read all content when text doesn't fit on one. And press left to scroll up. I'm going to select continue. And finally, another option appears to confirm. This is for normal confirmations. Later in the video, I will show you when each one is used. Press both left and right at the same time to confirm. And that's all. Look, it's very easy. You are now ready to use your Trezor. If you want to see the tutorial again, press the left button. I'm going to press the right button to continue with the setup. Here, you can choose to restore a wallet that you are already using. For example, if you already have the Trezor 1 and want to transfer your funds to this wallet. Or you can choose, create a new wallet. If you want to restore a wallet, you must continue the process on the device. Here you accept the terms and conditions. press the right button to continue with the recovery process. And now, you choose the number of seed words you have. In this wallet, you can do the recovery process using 12, 18, 20, 24, and 33 words. The most common are 12 and 24 words. I'm going to select 12 words. Here it appears. You'll only have to select the first two or four letters of each word. Here it says, position of the cursor will change between entries for enhanced security. The first word is alarm. I'm going to select the first three letters, and the device automatically displays the word. I select it by pressing both buttons. And so you put the 12 words, and that's it. For this video, I'm going to create a new wallet. Here are two options for creating recovery seed words. You can choose the standard seed words. These are the most used. Or you can also choose Shamir Backup. This is a more advanced way of generating seed words. It makes it even more difficult for thieves to take our funds, but it is also more complicated to use. So to avoid complicating your life, I advise you to use the standard seed words. Here on the device, you press the right button to continue with the creation process. And that's it. The new wallet is created. And now the most important thing, you must create the backup. In order to continue with the process, you must read these security recommendations and select these three checkboxes. Remember, never take photos or make digital copies and always keep them in a safe place. Here on the device, it reminds you again to never make digital copies of your backup or keep them online. To confirm, press both buttons at the same time. And now the 12 words are appearing for you to write. Select Show Words. Here the numbered words appear. This is very important. Always remember to write them in order. With the right button, you go down. And when you finish, you press the right button. And here you confirm that you have already written the 12 words in order. Press the right button for a few seconds, and that's it. Now, the device will ask you to select some words out of order to confirm that you wrote them in the correct order. Press the right button to continue. Here it appears. Select the third word. The third word is struggle. You confirm by pressing both buttons at the same time. Now select the seventh word. Word number seven is minute. You select it and confirm. Now select the 10th word. Word number 10 is table. You select it, confirm, and that's it. The message that the verification of the seed words has finished appears. I go to select continue, and the message appears that the backup is done. The next step is to set up a security pin. With this pin, you will generate an additional filter and thus prevent strangers from using your device. You select continue to pin, and now set pin. The device asks you if you want to activate pin protection, and informs the pin will be needed to access the device. Press the right button to continue. The pin should be a minimum of 4 digits and a maximum of 50 digits. Here it says, position of the cursor will change between entries for enhanced security. This means that after you confirm a pin digit, another number will randomly appear. I'll show you how it works. So, I'm going to create pin 2438 as an example for the video. Here I am going to select the number 2, and with the two buttons, I confirm it. The next number is 4. And look, once confirmed, another number randomly appears. This is done by the device for security. The next number is 3. I confirm it by pressing both buttons at the same time. And finally number 8. I am going to confirm it. When you finish selecting the numbers, look where it says enter and confirm. And now, like any password, you must enter it again so that it is confirmed. And that's it. The message appears that the PIN was created correctly. Now, the next step is to activate the cryptocurrencies you want to add to the wallet. You select the ones you like the most. And here you complete the setup of the Trezor wallet. If you want, you can only add one or two here, no problem, later you can add more. Here you can see that in the Ethereum, Ethereum Classic, Solana, Cardano, and Polygon cryptocurrencies, you can also add tokens from those blockchains. That does not mean that you can store all the tokens of those blockchains, Trezor is gradually adding them. If you want, you can change the name of the device here. You write it. And the device asks if you want to change the name. With the right button, you confirm. And that's it. You can now open the Trezor suite to receive and send your cryptocurrencies. I'm going to select Standard Wallet. If you want to add a passphrase to generate even more security, you can configure it in the dashboard here at the bottom. If you want to configure it, I recommend doing so before depositing funds. Here in the bar on the left, you will find all the cryptocurrencies that you added. If you want to add more coins, you can do so by selecting this icon. Now, I am going to select the Solana currency to explain how to receive and send. To receive, you can select any of these two buttons. This option is to buy Solana directly with a credit card. I do not recommend it. Avoid buying cryptocurrencies with credit cards as much as possible, neither in these wallets nor in exchanges, because the credit card fees are very high. I am going to select Receive Sol. Here is the address. Select Show Full Address. And the Solana address appears on the device so you can verify that everything is correct. If you want, you can also see the address in QR code. I will confirm. Now I copy the address and go to the exchange. I already have the Solana currency selected. Here, I paste the address. I enter the amount. I pass the security filter, and that's it. Here, the Solana already appear in the wallet. And now to send them. Here, you select Send. I'm going to copy the address of the other wallet. I am going to send them to the MEXC Global Exchange. Here you must paste the address. You can choose to send everything you have. Or you can directly enter the amount of Solana you want to send. You can also enter the amount in dollars, and the wallet automatically shows you how many Solanas they are equivalent to. Now, on the device you will confirm the transfer. This is why Trezor is so secure. You cannot send any cryptocurrency without authorization on the device. Here 200,000 units appear. Just as in Ethereum the term gas is used, in Solana the term compute units is used. Each Solana transaction has a soft limit of 200,000 compute units. If the transaction costs more than 200,000 units, the transaction is reversed. These are technical data of the network. You simply confirm. And the address appears here, so you can verify that it is the same. Now, the amount appears. And the expected fee. I will confirm by pressing the two buttons. And in the app, I'm going to select send. Here it appears that the transaction is being confirmed. And that's it, the Solana have already been sent. Now, I go to the MEXC Global Exchange. And here it appears that the deposit was successful. And lastly, remember, whenever you are going to make a send for the first time to a wallet, whatever the brand, it does not matter. Use a very small test amount. You send it to the wallet, and you return that same amount. And so you can verify that everything is correct on the device. Well, that's all for this video. I hope you liked this information about this excellent wallet. And remember that in the video description, I leave you the link so you can buy it directly on the official website. See you in the next video.